Aloha everybody, Kai Waza with you, and greetings from Honolulu, where it's a not-so-sunny day, but it's very warm, so I don't know about where you are, but or what time of year it is when you're watching this, whatever, but things are pretty good here, and I thought I would take today to create another video of a seemingly endless series of me going through my 2,500 Hawaiian recordings, vinyl records that I've been collecting all my life, going through them one at a time and talking about them a little bit. We're on the letter P, and we're going to pick up where we left off on the last video, number 278 or something, or whatever it was. I don't even know at this point, off the top of my head. First record up today is, and believe it or not, today we will complete the letter P. We will complete it. This is a record from Japan. It does not have a date on it, but it's the it's called Hawaiian Symphonic Mood by the Polydor Symphonic Orchestra. As you can see there, it's all in Japanese, so, but the songs on it are all the sort of standard songs that all the Japanese Hawaiian songs records have on it, you know, your Red Sails and the Sunset and Blue Hawaii and all of that. They tend to have a lot of the same songs on it. Here's one from a bit of a celebrity from the television show Hawaiian Eye. This is Ponce Ponce. That's his actual name. I think on the show it was Kim. And I have seen this record released with the same cover art, same cover, but titled differently. I think Cab Kim from Hawaiian Eye or Cabby Kim or something sings. Anyway, but it's the same album. These are all like Hapa'ali standard songs, really cute versions. And he's, you know, he's a good singer, nice singer, and... what's interesting, though, is most of the lyrics, which are in English, on this album, they have changed up a little bit and altered the lyrics on most all of the songs. I don't exactly know why, but some of them are personalized to him, and some of them they just changed. I don't know, but it's curious, and it's a cute album, and I love the picture. The Huma Huma Nuku Nuku stops swimming by when Hilo Hera does the Hilo hop. That Wahine has an opu. With a college education, there's no motion she won't go through. She doesn't live a thing to your imagination. And it doesn't dance, no Lord. It's on Warner Brothers Records. Now here's a record. I wish I could get this one, a decent copy of it, but it's a kind of a budget label, Omega, and I think their records were mostly not just made out of vinyl. They were probably made off of, you know, plastic and garbage cans and whatever else they are melted down to make these. So the sound quality is never great on these, very scratchy sounding. But this is George Poole and his orchestra, Hawaiian Enchantment for Dancing. I've seen this one released on some other labels too. Same album, different title. Well, I think it's also called Hawaiian Enchantment. Just different label. I don't know if the quality of the vinyl on the other label is better. Maybe I should check one out. Here's a record out of Australia called The Beat of Polynesia by guitarist Peter Posa. This is an all-instrumental album. On Axis Records, I believe it's the only thing I have on Axis Records out of Australia, and not a date on it. Peter Posa and the Islanders. This is a cute record. I originally had it on CD, and I was hoping that it was originally an album, and eventually I did find it. It was because I would prefer to have the vinyl record in any situation. The world-famous premier accordion band Go Hawaiian. Now, I'm not necessarily a big accordion fan, but I just find this record sort of amusing and cute. It's all medleys. Some of the songs are more Hawaiian than others. They even do like a Jungle Book Disney medley. It's cute stuff, you know. Cute record. 1988, this is from a little bit later. Surprised that in 1988 a record like this would have been recorded, but on Scott Disc, but go figure, it was. It's kind of weird to me. 1988, who would have been buying this kind of music, a record like this, in the late 80s? I don't know. Okay, well, this artist, next artist, needs no introduction. I'm sure a million people have these records in their collection, so I'll just show them. It's very obvious. Elvis Presley, Blue Hawaii, one of his most well-known films. Filmed here and in California, both, but yeah, a lot of it filmed here. A lot of people think Blue Hawaii, that this is where the hit song Blue Hawaii came from, and his version of it was a hit, but originally the song Blue Hawaii came from the 1930s and was introduced in a Bing Crosby film called Waikiki Wedding, along with Sweet Leilani. That's where that song originally was from. See it blossom, see it grow. That's the story of our love. Ever since we set it up. I always think the song Ku'uipo from this film is sort of underrated. The Ku'uipo, I love you more today. Right, anyway. Kind of underrated, not that much appreciated, not understand why. I know one local group did pick it up much later and re-record it, but I don't know, I kind of felt like that song kind of is nice, and I wish more Hawaiian groups had recorded it. And then, of course, the film, Elvis Again, Paradise Hawaiian Style. Comes of the island, you're beating in my heart. You're with me no matter where I roam. If ever I wonder, if ever we're apart. I know that you will lead me home. If I should journey across the deep blue sea, I'll never forget these corals. Some nice songs on here too. This Is My Heaven, I like that song myself, personally. RCA, of course, these are nationally distributed records. Then we have a couple of records by a group called Pu'umana. This is Irmgard Aluli, sort of a legendary name. She had been around for 100 million years, and really a long time. Very active in Hawaiiana, Hawaiian music community, and wrote songs. Part of the Farden family, very famous musical family. This is Irmgard Aluli and her daughters, Irmgard and Pu'umana, with One Little Dream of You. This album came out in the 80s. And was really well received. 1982, beautiful album, beautiful harmonies, and nice songs. Really nice album. Very nice old style, Hawaiian music. Is a follow-up. They did another album. Is it a follow-up? I don't know. It's just another album. Pu'umana, Have a Smile. More of the same great style music, very similar kind of album. Beautiful stuff. I also really like that they stayed throughout, you know, their recordings were consistent to their style, and they didn't, you know, be like, oh, we're going to do a reggae song now or whatever. I like it. Okay, finally, we have a record from an artist that was performing on the island of Kauai, and that is Vic Punua. The album's called Memory Island. This is on Kolopop Productions.
Sail away with me to Memory Island. Strange enchanting, never say goodbye, land. Strolling on the sands of time together. Find the love we knew.
All right, that's Mr. Vic Punua. So that wraps it up for today. If you enjoy this kind of music, I invite you to tune into my online radio station called Hawaiian Hi-Fi, HI-FI, on live365.com. It's easy listening Hawaiian music, all from my vinyl record collection. Free to listen to. I don't make any money off of it. It's just a hobby for me to do, and I love it. Love doing it. That wraps up the letter P, believe it or not. So I don't have to draw. Normally at this time I would draw to see the next letter that we're going to do. But, you know, guess what? We're on the last letter of the alphabet. So it's J. On the next video, we will do the letter J. That's probably just going to be one video because it's very small. Then I'm going to do the budget label series and show that. So, okay, next video will be the letter J. Thank you and have a good week, guys.